Hello. So good to meet you at this Global Motivational Meeting. We are reading World Scriptural Book to inspire and empower a positive vibe. As we are reading this book from the beginning, please find all the chapters on our Messages to Billions channel. This book inspires billions of people and will help you to just read them and practice. Let's read further about decision. The moral life is a purposeful life. It requires a decision. People do not become good automatically. Those who just drift through life are liable to draw in its evil currents. At every turn, we encounter two paths, the better and the worse. And it is our responsibility to choose between them. The scriptures describe it as a decision between life and death. Between the narrow gate and the broad road, or between two masters. Father Moon teaches that each person stands in a midway position, according to the two directions by the opposing powers of good and evil. It is a contest between God, who speaks to us through the conscience, and Satan, who prompts us to satisfy our self-centered desire. And this difficulty says it is up to each of us to choose our path and keep to it. Man always stands at the crossroad of a good and evil. Both the good and the pleasant present themselves to a man. And the calm soul examines them well and discriminates. Yeah, he prefers the good to the pleasant, but the fool chooses the pleasant out of greed and avarice. Surely the path that leads to worldly gain is one, and the path that leads to nibbana is another. Understanding this, the disciple of the Buddha should not rejoice in worldly favors, but cultivate detachment. No one can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or he will be devoted to one and despise to other. You cannot serve God and Mammon. God puts forth a parable. A man belonged to many partners at variance with each other, and a man belonging entirely to one master at those who equal in comparison. The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hidden in a field, which a man found and covered up. And then in his joy, he goes and sells all he has and buys that field. The kingdom of heaven is like a merchant in search of fine pearls, who on the finding one pearl of great price went and sold all he had and bought it. Further, let's see quotes from the second guy, Messiah, Father Son, and Moon. I am the crossing point of good and evil. We live in a world where good and evil confront each other. Good and evil each pulls out divided mind and body. Evil pulls us toward evil and good pulls out toward good. Human beings stand midway between these two opposing forces. They become good or evil depending on which way they travel from the center line. You are wandering back and forth across this line. In the first, the human ancestors had no fallen, but had the reached perfection and became one in heart with God. Then they would have lived relating only with God. However, due to the fall, they joined in a kingship of blood with Satan, which compelled them to a deal with him as well. They found themselves in the midway position, a position between God and Satan, where they were relating with both. As a consequence, all their descendants are also in the midway position. How does God separate Satan from fallen people who stand in the midway position? Satan relates with them in the basis of his connection with them through lineage. Therefore, until people make a condition through which God can claim them as his own, there is no way God can restore them to the heavenly side. On the other hand, Satan acknowledges that God is the creator of human beings. Unless Satan finds some condition through which he can attack a fallen person, he also cannot arbitrarily claim him for his side. Therefore, a fallen person will go to God's side if he makes good conditions and to Satan's side if he makes evil conditions. How do we cross over the dividing line between good and evil? Good abides where we live for others, and evil abides where we live centered on ourselves. If you look within our original mind, always tries to lead us toward good through and the good direction. It says, serve others, have an affectionate heart for others, sacrifice for others, live for others, such is the path of goodness. If you act as your body desires, you are connected to hell. On the other hand, if you act as your mind wishes, you are connected to the kingdom of heaven. You alone are the divine line between the kingdom of heaven and hell. Do you know what spiritual food is? Even when you are hungry, if you have to choose between spiritual food and physical food, you should feel that spiritual food is tastier than physical food. Then you can survive and stand on the side of God. Living your life based on spiritual power should be much more appetizing than the taste of life lived with physical power. Looking back at my youth, I remember how serious I was. I was at the point of decision what to do with the rest of my life. At that crossroad, I knew that I should not let the humanistic concern determine my decision. Instead, I concluded that I had to make my decision in accordance with God's will. If I had not taken this path, surely I would be a powerful and respectful man in some secular field. I would be recognized for my intelligence. I have the ability. I could have risen to leadership in my nation. Yet instead, I choose a life filled with tears and sorrows. Even since I came to know God, I have shed tears for him. Do you think I am not capable to avoiding persecutions? Yet I endure and tolerate the persecution based because I know God's situation. He has gone through far greater tribulation than mine. Do you think that when I was a young man, I did not have any personal dreams and ambitions? I certainly had great ambition and dreams. But once I decided to go this way, I cut them off, and ever since I have never noticed any personal ambition. That is how I could become who I am today. So powerful quotes. If you will have difficulties today, please watch one more time this video, share this video as we end this billion happy life subscribers marathon. Contact me for consultation, cooperation, and become a member of this Heavenly Parents for your community. And wish you a great blessed day, and see you tomorrow with more powerful quotes. Yours, Coach Nikolai Serpala. All the best. Bye-bye.